In this video, we will try to understand how to draw shear force and bending moment diagram in case of cantilever beam. So as shown over here, we are having the cantilever beam carrying u.d.l as well as the point loads. And for this, we have to draw shear force and bending moment diagram. So let us first start with the shear force diagram. The conventions that we are using is upward force is considered as negative, whereas downward force is considered as positive. Now shear force at B will be zero because there is no force that is acting over here. Just at the right of C, it is also zero because there is no force that is acting between B and C. Exactly at C, it will be 5 kN. Just at the right of the D, it is 5 kN. And exactly at the D, it will be 5 plus 3, that is 8 kN. And for A, we have to take into consideration this effect of u.d.l, that is 2 into 3, so that is 14 kN. So using this, we can draw the shear force diagram over here. So at B it is 0, at C right it is 0, exactly at C it is 5 kN, D right it is 5 kN, exactly at D it is 8 kN and then 14 kN. So this will be the reaction at point A also. Now let us see the bending moment diagram. The conventions that we are using is clockwise negative and anti-clockwise positive. First we'll convert this uniformly distributed load of 2 into 3 into a point load acting at the center of 3 meter length, that is 1.5 meter. So now we have converted that u.d.l into a point load. I will start with point B. So bending moment at point B, it is 0. Bending moment at point C is also 0 because there is no other force that is acting on the right hand side of C. Bending moment at point D, we have to consider all the forces which are acting on the right hand side of D. So it is only one force that is there. So that 5 multiplied by perpendicular distance from C to D, that is 2 meter. So 5 into 2, and it is producing clockwise moment over here. So we can see over here, this is producing the clockwise moment about point D, and therefore it is negative. Similarly, bending moment at A, we have to consider all the forces which are present on the right hand side of A. So the forces which are present over here is 5 kN force, 3 kN force and this 6 kN force, and all of them they will produce the clockwise moment about point A. So start with this 5 kN force from C up to A, the perpendicular distance is 2 plus 3, that is 5. So 5 into 5, and as it is a clockwise moment, it is negative. Then this 3 into 3. Because from D up to A, again the perpendicular distance is 3, and that is also producing the clockwise moment. Then this 6 into 1.5, so that is also producing the clockwise moment. So that we have indicated over here. So total moment is minus 43 kN meter. So let us draw the bending moment diagram. Between A and D, there was a u.d.l, and therefore it is a parabolic curve that we have drawn over here. Now let us see another example. Suppose we are having the cantilever beam loaded as shown over here. So it is carrying u.d.l of 2 kN per meter, for a length of 5 meter and a point load at the free end. So let us start with the shear force diagram. Now we'll start with shear force at B. The shear force at this particular point B is 5 kN. At C right, it will be same, that is 5 kN. Then exactly at C also it is same because there is no other force is acting. And at A, we have to take into consideration this 2 into 5, that is u.d.l. So 5 plus 2 into 5. Now using this value, we can draw the shear force diagram as shown over here. So at B, it is 5. At C right and C, it is also 5 because there is no force that is acting between them. And at A, it is 15. So 15 kN load. Now let us see the calculations and diagram for bending moment. Bending moment at point B will be 0. Bending moment at point C. So we have to consider all the forces which are acting on the right hand side of C. There is only one force, that is 5 kN, and it will produce clockwise moment. And clockwise moments we are considering as negative, so it is 5 into 1, so that is minus 5 kN meter. Bending moment at A, we have to take into consideration the point load which will be producing a clockwise moment about this A, and the perpendicular distance from B up to A is 6 meter. So it is 5 into 6. So that is our first term which we have written over here. Then for this particular u.d.l, 2 into 5 will be converting that particular u.d.l into point load acting at the center. So this is 2 into 5. This will be our total u.d.l load in kilonewton, because for 1 meter length the load that is acting is 2 kilonewton and multiplied by 5 because this is the 5 meter length, and it will be acting at the center of 5 meter. So this will be 2.5 meter. And this will also produce the clockwise moment about point A. So it is 2 into 5 into 2.5. So total will be minus 55 kN meter. So the bending moment diagram will be like this. From C to A, as there is a u.d.l, there will be a parabolic curve. Now let us see another example on this particular shear force and bending moment diagram for case of cantilever beam. So the beam is loaded as shown over here. So it is carrying only the uniformly distributed load. So let us start with the shear force diagram calculations. So as you can see over here, there is no force that is acting at point B, so it is 0. At C right also, there is no force that is acting between B and C, it is 0. At point C also, there is no point load, so it will be 0. Whereas at point A, it will be 20 into 1.5, that is the u.d.l, that is 30 kN. So those, using this particular values, we can draw this particular diagram. So at B, it is 0. At C and C right, it is 0. And then it suddenly increases to a magnitude of 30 kilonewton at point A. I will draw the bending moment diagram for this special case. As usual, bending moment at point B will be zero. At point C also it will be zero because there is no force that is acting on the right hand side of C. At point A, we have to take into consideration the effect of this. u.d.l. So u.d.l. was 20 into 1.5 and allow it to act at the center of this 1.5 meter length. So only this particular u.d.l. is producing the moment about point A. So it is 20 into 1.5, that is the total load, and multiplied by the perpendicular distance from this point up to this point, that is half of this length, that is 1.5 upon 2 meter. And that will be minus 22.5 kilonewton meter. So at B it is 0, at C also it is 0, and at point A it is 22.5 kilonewton meter. And between C and A, as there is a u.d.l., it will be a parabolic curve that we have shown over here. So in this way we can draw shear force and bending moment diagram in case of cantilever beam.